Yes, welcome back to Fight Night here at Alexandria Basketball Stadium. Drury Forbes in commentary alongside the great John Harker as we get set for one of the more exciting fights tonight. It's the undefeated George Ferocious Cambosis Jr. up against one of Philippines' finest, Jobert De Los Reyes. And this should be an absolute cracker, of course. They're fighting for the PABA International Lightweight title. George Cambosis Jr. puts it all on the line tonight.
Yeah, I love this young bloke. He's a tremendous fighter. He really is going places. Held the interim title when the Russian couldn't make the weight. And this is the first time he's putting the full title on the line. Of course, had a terrific record as an amateur. Fought for Australia on many occasions.
So here is the Filipino, De Los Reyes.
15 fights for 10 wins.
Yes, he's got some good credentials, De Los Reyes. If Cambosis Jr. thinks it's going to be in a walk in the park, well, he's got another thing coming.
Yeah, he comes with a pretty good reputation. They say he's got a very hard chin, like many of the Filipinos. But he is 8-0, Cambosis Jr.
Of course, undefeated George Cambosis Jr. And here he is as the crowd gets right into this one. George Cambosis Jr. 8 wins, no losses. And all of Cambosis Jr.'s victories have come by way of either knockout or a unanimous decision. So they've all been comprehensive as he looks to continue his win streak to 9 here tonight.
Yeah, 4 stoppages and 4 unanimous points decisions. He's a beautifully balanced fighter. He's got fast hands. He's got a lot going for him.
Let's go down to MC David Tapp.
Ladies and gentlemen, great to have your company at the Alexandria Basketball Stadium as WAC Promotions now presents the main event of the evening. Before we introduce the fighters, would you please be upstanding to sing the national anthem tonight? Welcome, Andrea Vox.
Australians, oh, let us rejoice, for we are young and free. With golden soil and wealth for toil, gifts of beauty rich and rare in history's page that every stage advanced Australia fair in joyful strains and let us sing advanced Australia.
What about it for Andrea Vox? Well done. Beautiful rendition of the Australian National Anthem. This bout you're about to witness at Alexandria Basketball Stadium to be conducted over 12 three-minute rounds for the PABA International Lightweight Championship. Introducing firstly, fighting in the red corner, 21 years of age. His professional record is flawless. 8 victories, no losses. 4 of those 8 victories by knockout. Weighing in at 60.7 kilos. His nickname says it all. Give it up for Ferocious George Cambosis. And his opponent tonight, fighting in the blue corner, 26 years of age, born in the Philippines, but resides in Gunnedah in country New South Wales. He's won 15 professional fights, 10 of which have been by knockout, with 5 losses, 1 draw. He weighs in at 61.2 kilograms. Welcome tonight, Jobert De Los Reyes.
White down the corner there, please. Jr. White the corner down.
In the red corner. Up against De Los Reyes in the blue corner.
What is ready?
We're about to get underway. As we mentioned, John, plenty of fans here tonight to see Kambosos Jr.
Yeah, and I'm one of them. I really do like this young man. I think he's got a huge future in front of him. Great to see, by the way, too, Dr. Lou Lewis here tonight, as he almost always seems to be at a fight night. And he's been around a long time, a terrific supporter of the fight. Yeah.
And De Los Reyes residing in Canada, of all places.
Yeah, and it looks like he, when you watch that national anthem, looks like he is certainly proud of his adopted country as well.
So Kambosos Jr., as we see a nice little right hook to the ribs there on De Los Reyes to begin with. As we said, there's plenty of fans here to see Kambosos Jr., and I suspect even more watching the coverage here as part of our WAC Promotions Fight Night. And De Los Reyes defeating earlier in 2015 one of Kambosos Jr.'s rivals, Dara Foley. So really should provide a good challenge for Kambosos Jr. here tonight.
We just saw a hit or something there, though, that the right rip followed up with the left hook. Look, the left hook didn't connect, but you'll see Kambosos Jr. use that combination a lot tonight, I would think. And when it does connect, he'll stay hit.
Of course, Kambosos Jr., one of his strengths is his speed. You can see how quick he is with those hands, not allowing De Los Reyes to get too close at all.
Yeah, he's at a slight reach advantage, and at the moment he's staying out of danger and keeping his hands relatively low, but it doesn't matter because he's just quickly in and out. Good footwork, great hand speed.
So both fighters just sussing each other out here early. See Kambosos Jr., the aggressor early.
Both looking as if they want to counterpunch, and they're waiting for the other one to flinch. A little feint might work.
Yeah, exactly right, John. They're both kind of like a game of chess at the moment. Who's going to make the first move?
And then
eventually somebody does have to make the first move. So we see Kambosos Jr. with a nice little combination. Follows it up with the quick jab. 20 seconds to go in this first round.
And not much between them. Not a lot has landed for the Filipino, but Kambosos Jr. just on top, but really not a struck match at the moment.
Final few seconds. And a good finish there for Kambosos Jr. That's the end of the first round. And applause from the crowd. Looks like they're giving this one to George as we see him there in the red corner.
Yeah, De Los Reyes took a lot of those on the gloves. But as I said, there wasn't really much. 10-point must system, you'd probably give it to Kambosos Jr. But both of them really sussing each other out in that first round.
Yeah, neither fighter really yet to get going, but as you said, John, probably just to Kambosos Jr. that opening round. So straight into round two. De Los Reyes, the Filipino, coming out of Canada up against George Ferocious Kambosos Jr., undefeated after eight fights, putting his PABA International Lightweight title on the line here tonight and aiming to continue that winning streak. If you're watching Kambosos Jr. for the first time, note his speed, note how quick he is, how dangerous he can be on the counter as well.
And a little hint that he's going to switch then in the southpaw. He didn't. Trying to confuse his opponent for a moment.
So De Los Reyes looking to be a little bit more attacking in this second round. I think he needs to be.
Yeah, it could get him into a bit of trouble though as well.
He's stand back,
he
stand
already
back.
Looks well and truly outgunned for speed. And he's, as we mentioned, just so beautifully balanced, Kambosos Jr.
See how quick those counter punches are from Kambosos Jr. De De Los Reyes just looking to mix it up a little bit. Big left swing there from De Los Reyes.
Paul Nazari, a great supporter of Kambosos Jr., really thinks he's got a very big future. Could fight for a world title in a couple of years.
And he started so young, hasn't he?
Yeah. Again, good movement. The Filipino's just, as we mentioned, outgunned for reach, and at the moment not quick enough to get in and out and score. When he does get close, Kambosos Jr. just tying him up. It's intelligent boxing.
Well, it's Kambosos Jr., 21 years of age. De Los Reyes, 5 years his senior at 26. As we see, a few punches being thrown here. So De Los Reyes showing his repertoire here in the second round. As Kambosos Jr. looks to come in, so he takes center ring, just adjusting his stance frequently as well, as we see a few exchanges there. De Los Reyes starting to wind up a little bit.
Coming up with air, though, that little sort of half a second switch to southpaw, switch back. His head movement's terrific. He's making De Los Reyes miss pretty consistently.
Which, of course, can be very tiring.
Absolutely. But needs to do a bit more himself now. His corner is telling him to try and step up the pace of this fight a little.
A couple of big punches from both fighters just missing. Had they have connected, would have put their opponents into a bit of trouble.
And again, there's that little switch.
So that's the end of the second round, and we see De Los Reyes in the corner. Who'd you give that one to, John?
Oh, look, you've got to lean to Kambosos Jr. Just he's made his opponent miss a lot, but there wasn't a lot of scoring punches from him either. You know, I couldn't argue if the referees gave it to the Filipino. Like, it's a struck match, nothing. I think Kambosos Jr. has probably won the first. That one was, you know, a pretty even round.
So back into it for the third round. We've certainly seen De Los Reyes, the more attacking approach of late.
And that start to this third round was a little different as well. The shot to the body, he's been headhunting to this point. And maybe that is something he should try more often, as he has just done then. But with the hand speed of Kambosos Jr., that can be a little dangerous as well. When you've got an advantage of both reach and hand speed, someone's going to your body, leaving their head a little open.
As we see, Kambosos Jr. just happy to counter here. He's allowing De Los Reyes to call the shots. And just coming in on the counter, and as you just mentioned, John, getting De Los Reyes off balance on the counter.
Yeah, he's missing a lot, isn't he, De Los Reyes? And he's starting to really feel comfortable. Kambosos.
Left jab from Kambosos.
Another missed combination, and an easy point picked up at little jab.
Well, one thing you know about De Los Reyes is he won't die wondering. And nor can you afford to. He's certainly looking to take this fight to Kambosos Jr. We see Kambosos Jr. with a couple of connected jabs there.
Yeah.
Left jabs.
Yeah. Best moment of the fight for him.
Stop.
He's been showing everything that he's got in terms of class and speed. If the goal is to hit and not be hit, a perfect exhibition of it at this stage.
Another jab there from Kambosos Jr. De Los Reyes looks to move in again. He's got the center of the ring now, De Los Reyes. Kambosos comes in again, though. And De Los Reyes really just playing into Kambosos Jr.'s hand. But what is he supposed to do? He can't sit back and do nothing as well.
No, not when you give up the reach advantage that he is. But Kambosos Jr. is landing that left perfectly as the left foot comes forward, straight over the top of the left knee. And this has been a great round for him.
Oh, it certainly has. His most dominant thus far. Clinical performance here from Kambosos Jr. As you said, we're seeing just about the same amount of punches being thrown, but the difference is one box is hitting and the other isn't.
Yeah.
Or connecting, I should say. So the final few seconds of round three. De Los Reyes moves in again and just accumulating the points, Kambosos Jr. But De Los Reyes certainly giving it a good crack as he has to.
Yeah, no real damage being done, no. But this is the best round so far for Kambosos. And there's an example of it, even though it was only the right hand at the end that that actually landed in that combination, just how quickly he moves his head and makes his opponent miss it. We saw it again there. Terrific movement because he's got an economy of movement. He doesn't move, he only moves it as far as he has to do to make the punch miss.
Let's go.
It's a credit to Kambosos Jr.'s cardio as well. Just looks to be completely in his comfort zone, certainly fitness-wise.
Yeah.
So we're back out of the way here in the fourth round.
Stand back, stand back.
De Los Reyes, he needs to start connecting with a couple here. You wouldn't want him to go away completely from the attacking game plan.
Yeah, I think he's going to do more with his feet. At the moment, he's standing in a little bit of lateral movement and head movement, but it's not quick enough. And he's getting picked off. He needs to be moving Kambosos Jr. around the ring a little more. It's just all too comfortable at this stage for his opponent. But you know, you're in there, he would know already that he's outclassed in terms of hand speed. And he's really at the moment wondering what it is he can do.
Yeah, needs to find a way to get underneath as well, I think. Needs to get underneath him. Just needs to make sure he connects with that first punch so Kambosos can't come back on the counter.
Yeah, hard to come in off the back of your jab when your jab's not connecting.
Of course, De Los Reyes, as we mentioned,
keeping it up,
victorious over Dara Foley earlier in 2015, so that speaks for itself.
But when he does come in and try and get, you know, sit on his shoulder and potentially work away at the body, Kambosos is just leaning on him, holding him. They split again. He gets himself back into position. So everything's being fought on Kambosos Jr.'s terms at the moment.
One thing you certainly cannot allow if you're his opponent.
Oh, good shot.
Kambosos Jr. with the right, following up with the left that did connect.
Stop, stop. Stand back. Box. Stop. Keep your head up, yeah?
Little mark on his forehead. Beginning to egg up by the looks of that.
And as you said, John, this is exactly the type of fight Kambosos. Oh, he's dropped De Los Reyes here with a wonderful right.
So the right hand to the forehead. Down he goes. I don't think he's getting back up. Yeah, no, he's gone.
It's all over. George, ferocious, Kambosos Jr. ecstatic. He's dropped De Los Reyes here in the fourth round.
Nine fights, nine wins, five knockouts.
And have a look at the crowd here. We have a look at the replay. All of a sudden, he made a decision not to counter anymore. He came in, and there's the right. De Los Reyes just lost his feet.
And just looking at that, we'll just see where it connects here. We'll get a better view of this great camera angle. Yeah, look, that's taking him right.
Ferocious George Kambosos, if there was any doubts, you've put them to rest tonight by a clean knockout over Jobert De Los Reyes. You said you were going to come home with the title. You kept your word and you did it. He's a brave kid. He fought. It was a really good fight. Tell us what happened, mate.
Oh, mate, full respect to Jobert De Los Reyes. You know, he's beaten some quality guys. You know, he beat Borg, you know, and he got him with a good shot. Borg was going well, and he got him with a good shot. And he beat that other, I don't even know who his name is. He beat that guy, and he dropped him, I think, three times too. So, you know, I told you, I'm on another level to all these guys. I'm elite right now. You know, I just showed you again, the Australian public, why I am the number one. You know what? And you know what? I am looking for the bigger fights. I'm looking for the bigger fights, you know? I don't think no one wants to jump in with me after that. You know, so I look at BoxRec and I see number one, Tomlinson. Well, Tomlinson, if you want to get it on, let's get it on me and you.
Had a terrific record as a amateur, fought for Australia on many occasions.
So here is the Filipino, De Los Reyes.
15 fights for 10 wins.
Yes, he's got some good credentials, De Los Reyes. If Kambosos Jr. thinks it's going to be in a walk in the park, well, he's got another thing coming.
Yeah, he comes with a pretty good reputation. They say he's got a very hard chin, like many of the Filipinos. But he is 8-0, Kambosos Jr.
Of course, undefeated.
Found in nature's gifts of beauty rich and rare. In history's page, that every stage advanced Australia fair. In joyful strains, and let us sing.
For Andrea Vox, well done. Beautiful rendition of the Australian National Anthem. This bout you're about presents the main event of the evening. Before we introduce the fighters, would you please be upstanding to sing the National Anthem tonight? Welcome Andrea Vox.
Welcome back to Fight Night here at Alexandria Basketball Stadium. Drury Forbes in commentary alongside the great John Harker as we get set for one of the more exciting fights tonight. It's the undefeated George Ferocious Kambosos Jr. up against one of Philippines' finest, Jobert De Los Reyes. And this should be an absolute cracker, of course. They're fighting for the PABA International Lightweight title. George Kambosos Jr. puts it all on the line tonight.
Yeah, I love this young bloke. He's a tremendous fighter. He really is going places. Held the interim title when the Russian couldn't make the weight. And this is the first time he's putting the full title on the line.
Of course, George Kambosos Jr. And here he is as the crowd gets right into this one. George Kambosos Jr. 8 wins, no losses. And all of Kambosos Jr.'s victories have come by way of either knockout or a unanimous decision. So they've all been comprehensive as he looks to continue his win streak to 9 here tonight.
Yeah, 4 stoppages and 4 unanimous points decisions. He's a beautifully balanced fighter. He's got fast hands. He's got a lot going for him.
Let's go down to MC David Tapp.
Ladies and gentlemen, great to have your company at the Alexandria Basketball Stadium as WAC Promotions now.